In this video, I'm going to show you how to sync local files to Azure Blob storage using AZCopy. AZCopy version 10 became available in late April of 2019. The latest version has an option that piqued my interest. The delete destination parameter used with the sync option will sync a source folder to Blob storage and remove files from the destination if they're no longer on the source. Before that, real quick, please take a second to subscribe and click the bell icon to get notifications of new content. Click the bell icon. The sync and delete destination option gives AZCopy a feature comparable to RoboCopy with a mirror parameter, providing the ability to keep the blob container in sync with the local file system or other blob containers for that matter. This is a great option for ad hoc backups or anytime keeping an up-to-date cloud copy of a file structure is needed. This gets even better when combined with Azure Blob Storage Soft Delete. A soft delete will allow you to recover a deleted blob for any given number of days. Using Azure Sync with soft deletes has the potential to be a compelling backup option. Okay, enough of me yapping, let's get into the demo. Buckle up everyone, it's demo time. I'm gonna start out in my Azure Storage Account and I'm gonna create a blob container. This is gonna be the destination target for the sync operation. And I'll give this the name CIR AZCopy Sync Test. And I'll leave it private. Click OK. And now we have it created. So I'm going to go in, go to properties, and copy this URL. I'm just going to paste that right into here. And I really don't care that you're seeing it because this will be long gone by the time you watch this video. The next thing I'm going to do is come back to my blob, and I'm going to enable soft delete. Let's go down here. And what soft delete does is it allows you to recover files deleted. And here you can see it gives me 7 days to recover those. This isn't like a snapshot. This is just, think of it as a wastebasket. This is a precaution in case you need to recover anything deleted by mistake. So I'm gonna save that. And the next thing I'm gonna do is come to shared access signatures. There it is. I'll leave this with the defaults for now, and I'll just generate a SAS connection string. And what I need here is the SAS token, so I'm going to copy that. And then I'm going to come back to Notepad and paste that in. So that gives me the URL and the SAS token all in one string. I'll need that for the AZCopy command. Now let's go over to my local file. You can see I have a few of them open here. Here's the test data that I'm going to copy. But you know what? Before I do that, I need to download and install the AZ command. So here is Microsoft's website, and it has three different options for the AZCopy, Windows, Linux, and Mac. So you can get the file from here. I already have it downloaded, and I'm going to go over to, here's the download directory, and it's downloaded compressed, so I have that unzipped on the Windows machine. I'm just going to take this AZCopy.exe, I'll copy it, I'm going to bring it over here to C Windows System 32, and I'm just going to drop it in here. And it will prompt me for my password. Okay, so now I have the AZCopy command in the System32 directory. That's part of the path variable in Windows, so I should have no problem running AZCopy from the command prompt. And we can give that a try. Oops. There we go. That shows us all the commands available. I'm just going to clear that out. Okay, so now I'm going to go back to my source. You can see that I have a test data folder here under AZCopy test. And in it, I've just got a bunch of random files, different sizes, different names, but simple text files. That should be sufficient for testing. So I'm going to come over here. That's going to be my source. So let's start building this command. So I'm going to start with AZCopy. and I'll specify sync. Then I'll drop the path in. So that's the source first, and then I'm the destination. And remember, I have that right here. So I can just copy this. Close it with a quote. And there's a couple options I can put at the end. One is recursive, that will transverse subdirectories. That's on by default, so I'm going to leave that off. The other one, though, is delete destination. Since we're doing an initial sync, there's really nothing to delete at the destination, but I'm going to add it in here anyway. So I found 35 files and it's uploading them. Okay, to view these now, I'm going to use Storage Explorer. Here I am in Storage Explorer, and you can see I've got my storage account and my blob container. And if we go in there, we can see my test data folder. And if I go in there, we have 35 items. So that did exactly what we wanted it to do. It's the initial sync. Now let's pay attention to 30 through 35. Let's remove those and see what happens. So I'm going to go back to the source. And we'll just remove 30 to 35. So they're gone from the source. And I'm going to run this command again. So now you can see it deleted those five files, which is good. So let's go back into Storage Explorer. We'll do a refresh. And yep, sure enough, 30 through 35 are gone. Okay, let's go back to the storage account in the portal. And we'll go back to blobs and then go into the blob container. Here we can see test data showing there. And here are all the files. Now, one thing I wanted to show you in here is if I click this show deleted blobs, we should be able to see there they are. So that's because of the soft delete is enabled that I could go in and manage these as well. Okay, so that works pretty well. Let's go in and create a subfolder because I want to make sure that the recursive file sync is actually working without that option. If we go to folder, we'll call this test one. And I'll just copy all these right into there. We'll run this again. There it goes. It is uploading those files now. One thing I should point out, I ran into an interesting issue with this. The virtual machine I'm running this on had a single core. And when I was testing this, the AZ command would bring the processor to 100% and just hang. And what I found is that there's a bug in the version 10 that will exhibit that behavior on a single core machine. So I gave the virtual machine a second core, which it probably should have had in the first place, and that issue went away. So in case you do run into that, AZCopy, at least at this time, seems to require multiple cores in order to run successfully. Okay, so there's some great detail on what it did, and let's go back to File Explorer and do a refresh. And there's the test. Okay, so those files are located in that subfolder, so that is syncing recursively. Now let's go back and try something different. We're going to go back to the source, and I'll go into that newly created test folder, and I'm going to delete out a lot of them. This time I'm going to run the sync operation without that delete destination command. There it goes. So you can see it didn't actually delete anything. Now if I come back here, do a refresh, you can see all the files are still there. They weren't deleted from the destination, although they do not exist at the source. So let's run that command again, this time putting the delete destination back. There it goes. And a simple refresh again should show us, yep, it got rid of all those. So that's pretty cool that now with AZCopy, you can keep blob storage container in sync with a local file system, or vice versa, or between blob storage accounts. I even saw a note that you can use AZCopy now to copy data from a AWS S3 bucket into blob storage. So that's it for the demo. That is how to use AZCopy to keep blob storage in complete sync with a local file system. That is it. I hope you found this useful. Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell icon for notifications of new videos. Thanks for watching.